If I'm completely honest, I don't think I've ever been happy with my voice on any of our albums. It's like, even Uprising, I mean, I'm proud of it, but it's, I knew I had to step it up big time with this new album, and it took me like 6 months to track this album, and you can hear that when you listen to the album, and I'm so, so proud of it.
Kennedy's knocked this out of the park. Strongest vocal performance on any Bleed From Within album by far. You know, it's a cliched thing, like, yo, everyone's bringing the reggae, man. Like, this is his best performance by a country mile.
He stepped up his game so much. He's really developing his pitched vocals and finding his style. It's definitely the best his voice has ever sounded.
Kind of towards the start of the writing process, he was really struggling, both with his voice and writing parts that were good enough for the songs that were coming out of it.
On the run-up to recording the album, and down to Maidenhead and did pre-production for the album with Justin Hill. Working with him helped me so much. He's one of the most talented vocalists I've ever seen live, heard on CD, and just working with him and learning like technique from him and his ideas for vocal placements and all that stuff. It was the best experience I've ever had as a vocalist. Normally we would go to a studio somewhere and track with a producer that I've, or an engineer that I've never like met or I meet for the first time, but this time we've done it in our own studio in here with Stephen tracking. This is why we took so long, because it was such a comfortable environment and I was trying new things that I would never have had the confidence to try in front of some new guy that I've never met before, so it was such a comfortable environment, and I think again that brought out the best in my voice, and there is things on this album that I don't even think people would expect me to do as a vocalist.
We tracked all the vocals here and we had a lot of time to experiment with stuff, all the pitched vocals and stuff. A lot of that came to him like maybe 2 or 3 weeks after he tracked a song. He'd be like, oh, I want to go back into that chorus and try this pitch idea, and he would do it and we were like fucking mind blown, you know what I mean? But we wouldn't have had that, the luxury of doing that, if we were paying for time in a studio. We'd have had to cram it all into 10 days.
We were aiming to take about a month as well with the vocals. Everything was supposed to be written, everything was supposed to have been demoed, but obviously time didn't work out. It came to guitars and bass finishing and we were still short a few songs. We didn't have all the lyrics that we needed, we didn't have all the vocal patterns that we needed, but we got everything that we needed done, and we would spend, there were a couple of days that we would spend just writing.
I only had like rough lyrics and kind of rough placements in my head, so we were tracking vocals from like 10 in the morning till 7 at night, writing as we were tracking. And I've never done anything like that before. I would always like go into the studio with everything ready to go. So I think trying these new kind of spontaneous things at that moment was just a new experience for me. And I think sometimes like that first initial take that you do and you absolutely nail it, sometimes it's really difficult to replicate that.
I think that in the end, we've come out with much better lyrics, much better vocal patterns, probably better songs. Is there a point in rushing it? Are we going to rush it and put out our first album in 4 years that could have been better? You know, no one wants that. Our fans don't want that. We don't want that. Again, though, it worked out for the better, because all of these things sort of culminated in the album how it is now, and I don't think any of us could be happier with it.
We found a way to make money in the dark.
I remember listening to the old Bleed From Within material when I was younger and being like, oh yeah, that screams so high, that screams so low and stuff like that. Like, that's what you do. But there are vocal takes on the album that are by far the best he's ever done. I mean, genuinely, his best moments are all on this album.
Because I knew I had to really step up with this album, I was struggling to write. Like, I would write something and then scrap it, and like some of the songs I literally wrote lyrics for about 5 times and scrapped them. So Ali kind of stepped in and helped out a lot with the writing process. It blew my mind. He's such an incredible writer, and because he's a drummer, he's got a really percussive way of thinking when it comes to vocal placements, which is something, like some of the things he would do I would just never think of. So I think having him on board has really helped me step my game up in terms of my writing and my kind of vocal placements.
I've always been into that side of things. I've always been into lyrics and vocal structure and how a singer pronounces a word and how it accents a riff. And especially with being a drummer, you know, I think rhythmically there's something really fun about placing another layer of rhythm in the song. I wanted to get more involved in that in this album, and I guess it just kind of happened. We were just writing down ideas and I said, well, you know, that song's not got anything yet, why don't I try and do a full song from start to finish? And it was great fun, you know, I really enjoyed myself. You know, he was loving what I was doing, so it just made sense to sort of continue. And
there was a song on the album that Ali wrote called Bed of Snakes, which is about a really fucking weird point in his life. Literally every time I sing that song in the studio, I get goosebumps, because I can kind of, in a way, relate to what he was trying to say in that song. When the face of a man that never suffered a fall, breathe in and scream these words as you shiver. Rise up, lean into now. Our days are numbered now and forever. Rise up, lean into.
You'll hear it in the album. I think a lot of the standout moments are due to Kennedy's vocal abilities. This is the best performance he's ever given on an album.
A really great thing that we've done on this album is we've put a bit of focus on his melody, particularly in choruses. But Kennedy was quite unsure of himself to begin with. He's learned a lot about expanding his vocal range, particularly because it's the first time that the band has explored sort of pitch and in terms of vocals anyway. It's definitely expanded our horizons, and it's great that we're now able to do it. You know, there are a lot of songs as well throughout the album with pitch where I sing in the chorus or where I'm singing in wee parts of the song, and he's got layers in there as well. And one of the things that we found out really early on is that the voices worked really well together. There were some songs where the chorus was maybe calling out for something a little bit different, and I think that the two of our voices sort of working together, it's worked really well, and I'm excited to see what people think. Do you believe in these words you preach? I'm falling to call for this. Surrender is ever right.
For me, the chorus in Alone in the Sun is kind of a standout moment with Kennedy, because it's probably the most melodic chorus guitar-wise that I've ever written. And it needed something huge.
Best moments is definitely in Crown of Misery. The part where he says, "There will be hell to pay," it's just the most demonic sounding thing I've ever heard. I can't get enough of that. And also the chorus for that song is just the catchiest thing I've ever heard. There will be
hell to pay! My favourite Kennedy moment by a mile is the lyric, "Your gods will bow their heads in shame," on Rena. It is the most epic vocal take I've ever heard him do in my life. We fall by the hands of our own mistakes.
Your gods will bow their heads in shame. Era's a hard one to define. I think the best way to describe it and sort of what it means to me personally, it's a collection of stories, and it covers the time that we've been away as a band. I think 6 years is a long time to be away for a band of our size, and you know, a lot is riding on this album. I think there's a lot of pressure there. So, you know, we're reflecting on the past and we're reflecting on ourselves. You know, we're getting older, we're not getting any younger. The things that have happened both socially and politically and personally in all of our lives.
It was something that I'd been toying with for quite a while, because whenever I listen to, like, for example, a song or an album, it really reminds me of a certain point in my life. And even if I listen to that song 10 years down the line, it takes me back right to the way I felt in that exact moment. And I remember when we were writing this album, there was a point where we thought that we were never going to release it. The band was pretty much on the verge of breaking up, and the name really resonates with me, because in 10 years from now, I want to look back, listen to this album and think of that name, and be proud that we managed to come out the other end of everything that was happening. Kind of just inevitable that the band was going to continue, because we love doing it, whether we release albums on a record label or tour or whatever. I feel like the name just really hits home with me for that reason.
When I think of Era, I think that this album is the start of a new era, sort of thing. It's like, I mean, there were a few years there where the guys sort of took a backseat with the band, and a few things happened that made it really hard for them to continue at full speed and do all the things that they wanted to do. By the time I joined, everyone was ready to go. They were like, right, cool, we've had our break. I think probably to some of the other guys as well, that it might be a reference to that part of their lives. as a musician, it's all you want to do, it's all you think about.
Also, I think it's one of those names that people can really make their own interpretation of, because look at the state of the world we live in today, and a lot of the lyrics are quite political. So I guess the name has a lot to do with that as well. So it's kind of open for people to make their own interpretation.
This was such an insane thing for me to do. I mean, I've always drawn and painted since as long as I can remember. So having the honour to do this was just incredible. But don't get me wrong, the pressure was unbelievable as well, trying to please four of my best mates as well. Because I'm not used to like, even taking criticism, really, because I usually do artwork just for myself, just out of fun kind of thing. So this is definitely something I'd love to do in the future again. Just learned a lot from it. And yeah, I worked closely with the guys throughout the whole process and to get the best results. So
Davey's such an incredible artist. He's really expressive with the way he thinks and the way he paints. So I just sent him like the idea I had for the album name and a bunch of my lyrics, and he created that. And when I look at that image, I can totally see what I was thinking when we were writing some of the lyrics. So I think he nailed it.
This was something I thought a lot about for a long time during the, like, creating the artwork. To me, it's like everything you've ever been a part of throughout the band, and kind of leaving all that negativity behind and concentrating on the positive, kind of having like the hands and the roots tangled up in a fixed state kind of thing, and then finally reaching for that release, which is the new album, which is Era. It's like all the feelings you kind of had throughout this time and being able to finally focus on the kind of journey ahead. So
it really encapsulates the meaning of the album, particularly with the five hands sort of representing each one, representing one of us. I think that was a cool addition to it. And it makes it more personal, you know, sort of reaching up to this goal, this thing in our lives that we all need, that we all want, that we all work for.
I think the goal is just to tour as much as possible and play as many shows as we possibly can, because it feels like an age since we've played a gig, and I just cannot wait to play these songs live.
I'm just excited to get back out on the road and play shows. I miss it so much. And this is definitely the best material we've ever written. I feel like they were written to be played live.
That's one of the things that makes it so exciting, is that so many things could happen. We've done our best, and we're going to show it to the world, and whatever happens, happens. I mean, I would love to be able to say that we'll tour the world. I'd love to be able to say that we'll go and do things that we've wanted to do all of our lives. And I think that if things go right, it absolutely could happen. We're going to keep working on new music. I know that's something that the guys have all said. Moving on to the next album, swiftly, is something that we're going to do as well.
I'm trying not to have too many expectations, but we really believe in this album, and hopefully it'll take us places. But over our time as a band already, we've seen the kind of dark side of the music industry, and we still have passion for what we do, and hopefully that will show.
It's no secret that this has taken a long time to put together. So before the whole writing process, or even just as soon as it started, and before we had any plans to actually track anything, the future was kind of uncertain. I don't think we really knew where it was going to go. And that was very uninspiring. When you're trying to write music in that mindset, where you don't know where the band's going, and you've had, you know, everything's been piled against you since day one, it was quite disheartening. We wouldn't be where we are today if it wasn't for each other kind of doing the jobs that they had to do. That's kind of where it sits, you know. We wouldn't have been able to write the songs that we've got if it wasn't for Gunsey putting in the man hours at the start. We wouldn't have finished the album if Stephen hadn't walked into the fold at the point that he did. You know, Kennedy's vocal performance is probably, if this album does as well as we'd like it to, then that's probably a lot to do with Kennedy as well. As songs started to come together, we saw the light again. And just to touch briefly on lyrics, there is a lot of talk about light and dark in this, and it's kind of those points where personally we were in a darker place, and the light is that kind of us coming together and being like, right, okay, there's something there. The dark is 5 years ago, the light is sort of now. It might get darker again in a few years if no one buys the fucking album, but we'll see.